Hi, I'm Ola Jones, and I'm a ranger here at Fort Zeldin. As you can see, I'm wearing my mask in order to follow COVID-safe practices. My coworker, Alexandra McKinney, is also wearing her mask, staying 10 feet away, helping me record this. Today, however, I'd like to share some information to you about the Parry's Agave. So to do so, I'm going to take off my mask. I'm actually standing next to the Parry's Agave, one of 300 species of agave. The leaves grow in a beautiful gray-blue color, but be careful because the edges are spiked with thorns. The pear shape also helps protect from predators. One of these predators, mankind, has used it as a source of survival for over 9,000 years. Identifying a Parry's agave might be easier when the plant is in bloom, which happens once every 5 to 20 years. If you do come across an agave that is in bloom during early spring and early summer, make sure to look up because the stalk of the agave grows from the middle and can reach up to 20 feet high. From the stalk, various branches grow and flowers bloom from those branches in various shades of yellow. But because this stalk grows so suddenly, it consumes all the energy of the plant, which results in the death of the Parry's agave. But this isn't the end for the plant because this agave also produces pups or baby agaves, which start the process all over again. It's a good thing that this agave can produce so many pups because in the past, the Parry's agave was used by indigenous people and early settlers to produce food, sewing materials, candy, paint, and even makeup. There were many ways the Parry's agave could be used to produce food. One of these ways was to roast or bake the core of the agave. Now, the way you got the core of the agave was to trim and remove the leaves, and it would be the center, the heart of the agave. Roasted agave is said to have the flavors of sweet potato, molasses, and pineapple. Now, after roasting the agave, juice residue was left, and this was used to make paint to decorate buckskin. And girls even used this juice residue to paint their cheeks as makeup. The agave also provided a sweet treat. Agave is extremely fibrous, this part right here. If you were to chew a chunk of this fiber, it would produce a sweet juice. After chewing, the tough fibers were simply discarded. This is basically the original chewing gum. Children got an especially sweet treat from the agave. The crown of the agave was eaten as candy. The crown is closest to the dirt and can be found at the base of the agave. It is right above the root system of the plant. However, removing the crown can cause serious damage to the plant, so sadly, we won't be eating any candy today. One way the agave is used today is as a sweetener. Juice that comes from the core provides a nectar, which is used as a sweetener in many foods and beverages. The agave did more than just produce food. It also produced tools for sewing. If you look here, this top thorn of the leaf was used as a needle, and as you break it down, it connects fibrous strands, which were used as thread. The agave has become a very popular plant for landscaping purposes, but in the past, it was a source to provide the tools needed to survive in this environment. In addition, early Spanish settlers also used the agave leaves to make paper. Today, I want to show you how you can make paper from the Parry's agave. The indigenous people of Mexico are reported to be among the first people to use the agave to make paper. Paper from the leaves of the agave was made in a way that resembled the ancient way of making papyrus. Spanish settlers in New Mexico also used agave to make paper. Let's make our paper the traditional way. The first step is to make sure that you gather all the materials that will be needed. A large sharp cutting tool, a smaller sized cutting tool, a cutting board, a pen, and a book to put on top of the paper so it gets flattened. Remember that any Parry's agave that you use comes from public land unless you have permission from an individual property owner. Before you start this agave, make sure that you have gloves on. As you can see, the agave has really large thorns along its edge, and the juices from inside the agave can cause irritation to the skin. Next, what you're going to want to do is take your large, sharp cutting tool. And now you're going to remove the leaf of the agave. You're going to want to get as close to the base of the agave as you can. It's so cool how you can see the indentions of the previous plant that was laid up against the agave leaf. In doing reading, I found out that these same indentions are found in Spanish documents where they use the agave as paper. Now that you have your leaf removed from the base of the agave plant, you're gonna wanna go ahead and remove the spiked edges and the top thorn. Now, before you start these next steps, make sure you do wear gloves. So now that you have all the thorns removed from your leaf, you can start the process of peeling, which is gonna give you your paper. Now, if you have latex gloves, it's probably better to use latex gloves than gardening gloves, just because the nail helps you peel the top thin layer of the agave leaf. I recommend you do this next step where the sun is not shining on you, as this causes the piece of paper to curl up and dry too quickly. Now, once you have all the spikes removed and are away from the sun, take the bottom portion of the leaf that was cut from the base, and as you are holding the leaf down, carefully start to peel the top thin layer of the leaf, as I am doing now. You must do this slowly so you can be sure you are able to peel off a large enough section to use as paper. This is not the easiest process and might take you a few tries to get it right, but don't give up. Now that you have sections of the paper peeled off, take the book that you will be using as a weight and place it on top of the section of paper after you have smoothed it out flat. Let it sit there for about 10 minutes. After the 10 minutes and your agave leaf is dried, you can go ahead and take a pen and you're ready to write. Now your agave paper is ready to be used and written on. You can go ahead and write friendly notes to your friends via Zoom. Hi, Mom. Please don't forget to share photos of your paper with us.